Filipino-American activists held a protest in Los Angeles to denounce the expanded defense deal between Manila and Washington. Our North America Bureau correspondent Steve Angeles now joins us with details. Steve, over to you.
Yes, Carmina. Filipino-American activist groups protested at the historic Filipino town Gateway in Los Angeles with the message that they oppose the Philippines becoming a gateway for the U.S. military. Manila recently agreed to allow the U.S. military access to more military bases in the Philippines. It comes amid continuing maritime tensions between the Philippines and China in the West Philippine Sea and Chinese aggression over Taiwan. Activists have argued that the presence of the U.S. bases will only add to the tensions. And while it has been some 30 years since the last time America operated bases in the Philippines, one of its longest-running Asian allies, activists say military presence has a negative impact on the community, citing a few murders and rapes in near military bases. Other protests took place throughout the U.S., including New York. Now, while an activist have also launched a petition to call for the U.S. and Philippines to cancel the agreement. Carmina?
Thanks a lot. Our correspondent Steve Angeles there joining us live from L.A. Back here in the newsroom, President Marcos open to having a tripartite agreement among the Philippines, Japan, and the U.S., but that's only if it will not worsen tensions in the South China Sea. The possible agreement was first floated during Marcos's five-day visit to Japan. Marcos, however, clarifies details of the proposal have yet to be ironed out, but he believes the potential deal will not lead to a defense alliance similar to the North Atlantic Treaty Organization, or NATO.
Europe is different from Southeast Asia, so maybe not quite like NATO, but syempre, it looks like we are strengthening our partnerships.
The five-man panel tasked to weed out narco cops meets today to begin discussions on the review process. George Carino now joins us with an update. George, what more can you tell us?
Hi, Carmina. The Philippine National Police Chief General Rodolfo Azorin Jr. announced on Monday that the five-man advisory group will sort through courtesy resignation papers of senior police officers was set to sit down on an in-person meeting at the national headquarters. This morning, the PNP chief said he was waiting for former Defense Secretary Gilbert Teodoro, who is yet to arrive along with other members of the five-man advisory group. He said among topics intended for discussion is how they will finish the job in less than 3 months to look and see how each individual within the group will evaluate the third-level officers. He said that he took upon himself to make the draft so that they can have talking points to begin with on the Monday morning meeting. He said that they expect that the draft will be completed within this week, and hopefully, ideally, by today, because he will only seek the comments and reactions of the other members of the advisory group on the draft that he has forwarded. Remember, Carmina, that it's no less than Secretary Benhur Abalos of the DILG who said that whatever findings of the advisory group will be submitted to the National Police Commission, who will then submit the recommendation to President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The PNP chief said that any complaints or appeal would have to be made after the president has rendered his decision, and all those appeals would have to be coursed through the National Police Commission.
All right, but George, just one question. As they try to lay down the rules and the process, how different will these be from the already instituted rules in the NAPOCOM?
Okay, Carmina, because some of the he was asked whether they will also look at intel reports of other agencies. PNP chief said might be. We might have to look through it. And how about SALN? We might need it. He said that they might also look into it. It's totally, some of it are not necessarily different or similar from the NAPOLCOM rules. And let's say about the lifestyle check, they will also try to look at it because you have to remember that lifestyle is associated with SALN. You have to be religious with your salem, if you're a government employee or official, for that matter, Carmina.
Mm. But how do you then, how will they be able to do that? I remember there was one point when Secretary Benhur Abalos did say that this has nothing to do with lifestyle checks, but for the most part, that's what you need to look at to see. Their lifestyle, that's one, and also their bank accounts is another issue as well, George.
I agree totally with your observation, Carmina, and that's quite puzzling when Secretary Abalos mentioned that. I was there when he told us that the investigation is only limited to drugs and the lifestyle check is not included, because as one police official who observed on that press conference, he told me what requested anonymity, that you cannot do away with lifestyle check if you're talking about involvement in drugs.
Exactly.
To quote that official, he told me that meron bang in the vernacular, Carmina, meron bang magnanakaw na nag-display ng ninakaw niya at ginamit niya yung ninakaw niya sa araw-araw niyang buhay? Siyempre, wala.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to look at that. You need to look at that so that the study or the investigation can be provided with context and credibility.
Yeah.
Carmina.
So if they're not going to look at that, then they're only going to go by way of what? To be able to prove that these cops are actually involved in the illegal drug trade. What are they going to look at?
Well, let us, I think it's better for us to wait for the guidelines that will be set by the five-man advisory group. We're still awaiting updates from the Public Information Office. Actually, we requested a pool of coverage, at least a video coverage of that event. But they declined, and they said that they will just provide us with handouts of the events related to the meeting of the five-man advisory group. Carmina.
All right, thanks a lot. Our senior correspondent George Carino there joining us on the line. Thanks.